Hi, this is writer-director Nancy Meyers, and I'm going to give you my picks on TCM this month, where the star of the month is my favorite actor, Cary Grant.
Hello, friends and enemies.
I love the Philadelphia story. Cary Grant has a very interesting part in this movie. I love his C.K. Dexter Haven. He takes sort of a backseat to everybody else in the movie because, you know, unlike Jimmy Stewart, he doesn't fall in love with Tracy Lord because he's already in love with her from the get-go. In a movie chock full of dialogue, he may have the least showy part, but yet he's still so mesmerizing. There's a strong emotional underbelly to his debonair Dex, and so often with Cary Grant, he holds back his affection for Tracy, but he's solidly there for her, allowing her to fall back in love with him or finally admit that she never stopped loving him.
Little face.
Oh, Dex, I'll be on now. I'll promise to be on.
Be whatever you like. You're my redhead. Are you all set?
All set.
There's too many brilliant scenes in this movie to recount, but I do love this scene when drunk Jimmy Stewart knocks on Cary Grant's door in the middle of the night, and Stewart does all the talking, and Cary does all the listening, and he steals all the moments, if you ask me. There's even a moment, I believe, in this scene where Jimmy Stewart burps unintentionally, and Cary corrects him or says something like, "Excuse me?"
Excuse me.
And they both kind of start to laugh. And I was just picturing George Cukor directing and saying, like, don't cut, because it's such a great alive moment for the two of them. Bringing Up Baby, 1938.
Susan, when a man is wrestling a leopard in the middle of a pond, he's in no position to run.
This movie is the screwiest of screwballs. This, to me, feels like a movie where comedy was king. It seems the goal of every day was for everyone to be at their funniest, and they were.
Perfectly idiotic in those clothes.
These aren't my clothes.
Well, where are your clothes?
From their brilliant walk through the restaurant when the back of Katharine Hepburn's dress was ripped and Cary walks so closely behind her so no one can see, she yells at one point, "Get closer," and he says, "I can't get any closer." I mean, the walk alone was just so brilliant. Throughout the movie, Cary Grant continually can't get a word in with her.
"Oh, I don't want to wear this thing. I just want to get married."
Tries in almost every scene. He opens his mouth to say something, but she never stops talking, so he always gives up. He plays frustrated, flummoxed, bewildered, having to deal with not only this madcap girl, but a leopard named Baby. He ends up in a woman's feathery dressing gown. At one point, he has a fishing net thrown over his head, and because of her, he also lands in jail. What can I say? The whole thing is just laugh out loud funny. It's a wonderful performance from Cary Grant. It's truly unlike any other movie he's ever made, any other performance he's ever given. Cary Grant did 5 movies with Hawks: Bringing Up Baby, His Girl Friday, Only Angels Have Wings, I Was a Male War Bride, Monkey Business. They were just an absolutely great team. The Awful Truth, 1937, is a classic movie of remarriage. It's maybe even the original. Cary Grant and Irene Dunne had a very special chemistry as actors. Their timing was everything. Their repartee always seemed incredibly natural.
Remember?
You never feel they've learned their lines. It just feels like that's how these two talk to each other. They not only finish each other's sentences, they also finish each other's expressions.
As we go down life's highway, you going your way, and I going my way.
Yes, well.
Okay?
Right.
Their tit-for-tat is classic film acting, and I'm afraid might be a bit of a lost art. His Girl Friday from 1940. In this movie, for me, Cary Grant solidifies his standing as the greatest of all time.
Excuse me, madam, are you referring to me?
Wait. He's the coolest, smartest, funniest, and cleverest of all of his ex-husbands that he's played. And for me, this is one of the most romantic movies because Hildy, played by Rosalind Russell, is his best reporter, best pal, ex-wife, and future wife. And when she tells him she's getting remarried, it's a really interesting moment.
It's here, it's a ring. Take a good look at it. You know what it is? It's an engagement ring.
Because his bravado evaporates.
Engagement ring.
The cocky guy he's portraying just simply goes away.
I tried to tell you right away, but...
And it's really interesting because Howard Hawks does not cut off at that. He holds on him for quite a while as that sinks in for him and for us.
I know you, Hildy. I know.
To me, that scene is one of the best scenes in any movie that I've ever seen. I love the staging. I love the writing. And the performances are as synchronized as the most beautiful ballet or an exquisite duet. It's two actors doing their absolute finest work and at a breakneck pace. And the cutting of the scene doesn't create pace, which is what happens in a lot of movies today. Everything's almost done in a two-shot, and they take your breath away with their performances. This is a remake of The Front Page, and it was Howard Hawks' idea to take a play about two men and make one of them, the one who wants to leave working and have a normal life, to make it a woman. And I have to say that was really just a brilliant stroke. North by Northwest, 1959. Cary Grant did four movies with Hitchcock: Suspicion, Notorious, To Catch a Thief, and North by Northwest. They were all great films, but there's something about North by Northwest that has made me see it over and over and over. The character of Roger Thornhill is a perfect match of a character to an actor. He's modern, he's elegant, he's a big city guy. You know, Cary Grant couldn't really play the everyman. He was a one-off, the exception to the rule. A man for the modern, sophisticated world. I can't imagine anyone better to play Roger Thornhill than Cary Grant.
That's my trademark, rot.
Roger O. Thornhill. What does the O stand for?
Nothing.
If I could tell you to watch just one scene that epitomizes what's so great about North by Northwest, I would say watch the scene where Cary Grant meets Eva Marie Saint on the train.
I never discuss love on an empty stomach.
You've already eaten.
But you haven't.
The writer Ernest Lehman outdid himself here. The dialogue is so excellent, so witty, so provocative. And the actors make it seem so easy and so natural. And it's also cut so well because you miss nothing. It allows you to see every reaction to every line, which I think is super critical in a scene like this. Alfred Hitchcock may be the master of suspense, but I also think he's the master of romance and flirtation.
Handle with care, fellas.
In there.
I'm valuable property.
In.
Cary Grant is the urban, sophisticated king of the screwball comedy, which makes him one of the founding fathers of the romantic comedy. He was the master of the comedies of remarriage, where he often played an almost unintentional, accidentally divorced man. And I can honestly say Cary Grant is hands down in all of cinema my favorite ex-husband. Pauline Kael pointed out in a piece about Cary Grant that she wrote back in the 70s that in his films, both comedies and dramas, he was pursued by women as much as he pursued them, probably even more. Katharine Hepburn, Audrey Hepburn, Eva Marie Saint, Ingrid Bergman twice, they all unabashedly wanted him. Seems to me the more he held back, the more the audience would be riveted by him. And what I love about him, particularly in his comedies, is how he never plays a love story for straight romance. He can be frustrated by his co-stars, especially in the screwballs, but he always laughs with them. His love interests became his best pals. They were a team as much as a couple. I've never seen another actor create that particular kind of dynamic again and again. Now, what about the way he looked? Cary Grant was stunning to look at and wore a suit like nobody in the history of film. His suit in North by Northwest is almost a character in that film. And he let directors use his good looks. In North by Northwest, when he's escaping from the hospital and the female patient whose room he sneaks through yells, "Stop!" thinking he's an intruder, he then takes a look at him and whimpers.
"Stop!"
He was in on the joke. He understood Cary Grant better than any of us. He understood something about acting that's a wonder to watch. He was endlessly inventive. When Audrey Hepburn asks him in charade,
"Do you know what's wrong with you?"
He says, "No,
what?"
And she leans in and says,
"Nothing."
She spoke for all of us.